वर्चुअल क्लास ऑफ म्युनिसिपल कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ ग्रेटर मुंबई एजुकेशन डिपार्टमेंट. आई एम मिसेस अक्षता काले एंड टुडे वी विल लर्न ईवीएस. कम ऑन स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस बिगिन अवर लेसन. सब्जेक्ट इज एनवायरमेंटल स्टडीज पार्ट 1 ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 5th एंड द नेम ऑफ द लेसन इज एनवायरमेंटल बैलेंस. Students, there are innumerable types of living things on the earth, and we can see different living things in different places. Here, where the animal or the bird fulfills its basic needs like food, water, and shelter, in that place it lives. In the last lecture, we studied about biodiversity. We will take a quick recap of all those and will proceed. The variety we see in all the living things that belong to a particular area is called the biodiversity of that place. See this? Here, this is the biodiversity in a river side. Correct? Here, we can see different animals, plants, and different birds are there, small insects are there. So many living beings we can see here. Along with that, we can see the non-living things also, like water, sun rays, correct? Means this all together make a biodiversity at riverside. Yeah, this is the favorable place for all these animals. Their fundamental needs are fulfilled in this area. So, they stay in that place. The environment, the surroundings, and the conditions in those surroundings which affect the life of the organisms there are together known as their environment. Here, the environment includes living as well as non-living things. We study about the components of the environment. Environment includes many components such as sunlight, water, air, plants, soil, and animals. See, dear students, here sunlight, air, water, and soil are non-living, while plants and animals are living things. And here they depend on each other, because plant needs sunlight and water to prepare its food, correct? It also needs soil. Air is necessary for us also to breathe in, correct? Like this, we depend, means here all the components, they are dependent on each other. Living and non-living things are dependent on each other. There is a lot of give and take or interaction between them. See, dear students, look at this. Observe carefully. See this, there are several links in this chain. This is a chain. And there are several links. They together make the chain. If the links were to separate from each other, could they be called a chain? No, correct? Even though each link is a complete object, it is joined to the links before and after it. If any link comes loose, the chain is broken. Correct? See, this is broken chain because one link is separated. Got this, students? Like this only, one more link and one more chain we will study. See, this is the sun. Here we can see the plants or grass with small insects. This is a grasshopper and this is the bird. Correct? Here also we can see the chain. From the sun, grass is there, and from the grass it is linked with the grasshopper, and grasshopper is connected to the bird. Here the plant or the grass and the grasshopper and the bird, they are connected to each other like a links in the chain. So this is called food chain because the grasshopper feeds on the grass and the bird feeds on the grasshopper. For the students, here also we can say each one is a link. See, grasshopper is a link and this plant or grass is also a link in this chain. See, this is also a food chain. This is a corn plant. Corn plant or corn is the food for the rat. And rat is the food for the owl. Here all the three are, they are linked and they are connected to each other for food. So this is called food chain. See here one more. Here we can see four links. See, carrot is the food of rabbit and rabbit is the food for fox and fox is the food for lion. Got this, student? This is also a food chain. Means they are connected to each other for food. We get so many food chains in our environment. One more food chain we will study, a lengthier one. By the help of the sunlight, the grass prepares its own food. There are some insects on the grass. The grasshopper, it eats the leaves, the grass, and also the small worms present in the grass. And this frog, it eats grasshoppers. And frog is the food for snake. See the chain? And snake is the food for eagle. And when eagle dies, the microorganisms feed on that. So, lengthiest food chain. Each one is a link. Here we can replace frog with the mouse. See this again. The grasshopper eats grass and the mouse eats grasshoppers. And you know that mouse is the good food for snake and snake is the food for eagle, and eagle, when it dies, the microorganisms feed on that. Got this, run? This is the one of the food chain. Here, The algae present on the water, still water, they get the sunlight and they prepare their own food. And in the river, the small marine animals, they feed on algae. And the small fishes, they feed on marine animals like prawns and all that. And the human beings, they feed on the fish. Or the fish is the food for humans. Like this, so many chains we can see in our nature. Yes, students, in nature there are three types of animals. Number one, herbivorous animals. Herbivorous animals are those who feed on plants and grass. Okay? And another one is carnivorous animals. They feed on the meat of the other animals. Means they eat other small animals. And omnivorous animals means they feed on both. Means they eat plants also and they eat meat also. Okay? Here in this food chain, like zebra and deer, they are herbivorous animals. They feed on plants. Okay, their food is plant. And the lion and the wolf, they are carnivorous animals and they feed on the herbivorous animals, mean plant eating animals. This also we can see in the food chain. Now we will move further. See, this is the picture of spider web and the world wide web. Here one thing is, or one line is connected to the different lines. Web means here one part, you can say, is connected to two or three parts, isn't it? So we call that one as web. Here also in the food we can see the food web. We'll study about that. See, this is a food web. Means here we can see so many food chains in one food web. Here one living thing, for example, you will take a butterfly. Butterfly is the food for frog also, and butterfly is the food for dragonfly also. Okay, one more you can take, rat. Rat is the food for snake also. Rat is the food for wolf also. Rat is the food for eagle also. Means we can say that one living thing can be a part of a number of food chains. That gives rise to a food web in nature. Means in this picture we can make so many food chains. See, this is also a food web under the water. Here also the algae and the small fishes, they are eaten by different animals. Here also we can see different food chains to make one food web. The most important food in food chains is nothing but plants. Every living thing gets its food from the environment. Many animals in the environment eat only plants. Just now we studied about herbivorous animals, correct? Other animals eat the animals that live on plants, means carnivorous animals. But plants make their own food in the presence of sunlight using water and the carbon dioxide from the air. It means that plants are the main support of every food chain. You can see here the plant is getting sunlight from the sun and it is getting water and minerals from the earth, and it is preparing its own food in presence of carbon dioxide. So plants are called as producers. How the company produces the materials or the products, like that plant produces its own food and it gives the food to all other animals too. Means directly or indirectly we all are dependent on the plants. See dear students, this is a food chain. See, here plants are called as producers because they produce the food. They take the help of sunlight in presence of carbon dioxide. They use water and mineral from the soil and they prepare their own food. And the herbivorous animals, see here giraffe, it feeds on plants. And the carnivorous animals like lion, it feeds on giraffe or other herbivorous animals. Got this? And when these lion or the carnivorous animals, they die, the microorganisms, they feed on that animal's body, like fungi and bacteria. Okay? And they decompose the body of that animal and they make a product or the material which is very useful for the plants. Students, we will go through water cycle. This we have studied in the last chapter, correct? Okay, then also we will go through once again. Water on the earth evaporates continuously due to the heat of the sun. Right? You can see here number one, evaporation. Water that has percolated into the soil also evaporates due to the heat and enters the atmosphere. And in the second year, transpiration means water evaporates through plants too. Leaf of the plants. Okay. As water vapor is lighter than air, it rises high up into the atmosphere. As it goes higher, it cools and condenses, forming very fine droplets of water. See there, number three, condensation. The droplets are so small and light that they float in the atmosphere, forming clouds. Okay? These small droplets join together and form bigger drops which are heavy. They cannot float. See their precipitation also. Such drops of water fall down on the earth in the form of the rain. Got this? Again the procedure follows. Here this process of evaporation, condensation and rainfall go on in a continuous cycle. This is known as water cycle. Okay? This is one cycle in the nature. Remember the different cycle. We studied just now water cycle. Okay? You are familiar with this picture. This picture is of photosynthesis, correct? Okay, see this picture. Here, all living things use oxygen from the air for breathing and give out carbon dioxide, correct? We also take in oxygen and we give out carbon dioxide. But plants use the carbon dioxide from the air for making their food. You know, during the photosynthesis, they are in need of carbon dioxide. Correct? Oxygen is given out in this process. They take in carbon dioxide and they give out oxygen. And we human beings and other living things, we take in oxygen and we give out carbon dioxide. Correct? And the oxygen is given out in this process, is added to the air. And the carbon dioxide given out by the other living things, it also added to the air. Like this, here also we can see one more cycle. This is called oxygen carbon dioxide cycle. Okay. We will study about nitrogen cycle, which is very, very important cycle in the nature. Okay, dear students, here microorganisms play very important role in this. The microorganisms, they decompose the dead animals and the plants residue, the excreta of the animals and all that. They decompose and they make a substance which is very useful for the plant. And that substance is added in the soil. Plants use that substance and it grows. And when it dies, the substance again mixes with the soil. Like this, cycle goes on. Got this, students? This is called nitrogen cycle. There are several other such cycles in nature. Thus, there is interaction amongst living things and between living and non-living things in nature. The interactions go on continuously. This helps to maintain the food chains in the environment. When the various cycles in the environment go on uninterrupted, environmental balance gets maintained. Now we studied about water cycle, nitrogen cycle, oxygen and carbon dioxide cycles. Like that, so many different cycles are there in our environment. Okay? Now we have completed our lesson. Now we will go through true or false. First one, microorganisms form a part of the environment. Come on, tell me, is this true or false? Yes, you are right, this is true. Microorganisms form a part of our environment and they play very important role in the environment. It is necessary to maintain biodiversity. Yes, very true. We have to maintain the biodiversity. Third, a grasshopper eats birds. Yes, you are right. That is false. Birds eat grasshopper. Correct? Thank you, students. See, this is a balance, you know, this is called physical balance. You know this, correct? Due to human interference, these cycles may break down and can cause an environmental imbalance. To maintain the environmental balance, we must take care of our nature, right? And not to harm or pollute it to satisfy our comfort. We must opt for reduce, reuse, and recycle. Okay? Thank you very much for being a part of this lesson. Please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon to get new updated videos.